measures that should be taken against the depleting of the ozone layer. If the ozone layer is depleted, it may lead to an increase in ground level temperatures, which by the UV rays, or also known as ultraviolet rays, would have reached the end, not blocked by the ozone layer. If this happens, they will have effects on humans, animals, and vegetation. These effects include, it may bring harm to human health. If someone has received more of these UV rays, you may end up having skin cancer, sunburns, and premature aging. More of the effects on human harm is it may damage some parts of the eye, including the lens, cornea and retina, and it may also cause immunosuppression. Immunosuppression may also be referred to as weakening of the human immune system. The UV rays may also have adverse impact in agriculture, forestry. If there are more UV rays received by the vegetation, most of the species will be vulnerable to these UV rays. It may result in reduced flowering, photosynthesis, and even growth. Some of these species include wheat, rice, barley, oats, corn, soybeans, and etc. Some of you might know that these crops, some countries depend on them, and if they are not there, they will starve. The other effect on the depleting of ozone layer is on the Canadian agricultural sector, and this could be significant. Only a few commercially important trees have been tested for these UV radiation sensitivity, but any results suggest that plant growth, especially in seedlings, is harmed by these UV rays, thus leading to loss of many species of crops. The UV rays may also cause damage to marine life, particularly plankton. Plankton, some of you might know, but some might not know, but I will tell you what planktons are. These are tiny organisms in the surface layer of oceans, mostly known as fish food. If they are threatened by the increased UV rays, planktons, if planktons are threatened by the UV rays, fish may end up not having food. That's leading to fish dying, marine life disappearing due to planktons. As planktons, they are the starters of the submarine food chains. The other effect is on animals. In domestic animals, UV exposure may cause eye and skin cancers. Species of marine animals in that developmental stage have been threatened in recent years by the increased UV rays under the Antarctic zone law. The depleting may also have an effect on materials like wood, plastic, rubber, fabric, and many construction materials, as they will be degraded by these UV rays. And the economy will have an impact on failure to replace those materials, as that could be significant. And measures that should be taken against the depleting of the ozone layer are buying and using recycled products, saving energy, using of public transport can do a lot in combating zone layer depletion. And spreading awareness can be the other factor, the other measure against the depleting of the ozone layer. And the international agreements such as Montreal Protocol in 1987 have helped in reducing the controlling industrial emission of CFC. And with this, I thank you.